As the sun shines in all of my glory, my flaws don't look so bad at all. What was I so afraid of?
Hey everybody, it's Charmelle. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. So today I am here with a perfume haul, so let's get right into it. So back in like, I think September, maybe October, I was telling you guys that I was in the process of building my perfume collection, and since then I've gone a little crazy and I've purchased a lot of new scents. So I wanted to do a haul for you guys, and the thing about all these purchases is that they were blind purchases. So I did not smell any of these in store before purchasing. I just purchased these based on the research that I've done. I've watched a lot of fragrance reviews here on YouTube. I've been searching the internet and all of that good stuff. So I'm going to let you know if some of these popular fragrances, if they are actually good or if they're overhyped. So let's get into this video. So before we get into the first scent, I do want to say that I already know that I like fresh and floral scents. So all of my purchases are either a fresh or a floral scent. Because these were blind purchases, I didn't want to get too crazy and do something completely out of my comfort zone, because perfumes can be expensive and I just didn't want to waste money on scents that I know I wouldn't like. So I'm going to start with the fresh scents first. The first scent is this Dolce & Gabbana Light Blue, and this is Love in Love. This one was actually gifted to me. According to the official details, this is in the fresh fragrance family. It is a fresh citrus and fruit. The key notes are citrus, raspberry, gelato accord, and cedarwood. And I love the way that this smells. This is just a very, just fresh scent. I that's the best way to describe it. It smells like you just took a nice shower or bath and you just smell clean. Yes, I think this is a great everyday scent. If I was still working in the office every day, this is definitely a scent that I would wear to work regularly. So depending on where you work at, you know, you want to smell good, but you don't want your scent to be too overbearing or overpowering, because sometimes it can be offensive to other people. So this is definitely a good scent that just smells good. You know, people get a nice whiff of you when you walk by, but it's not too offensive and strong. So again, this is Dolce & Gabbana Light Blue Love in Love. Yeah, I love it. Just smelling it now just smells really good. So the next perfume is actually a classic, and according to the details, this is described as a floral, but for me, it kind of falls in the fresh scent, and this is the famous Chanel No. 5. As popular as this is and how long it's been around, I had never actually smelled this scent, and yeah, I just thought it was something nice to have in my collection. It is actually in the floral family, and it is a powdery floral. It has a word that I cannot pronounce, aldehydes, jasmine, neroli, and sandalwood. So when I was doing my research on this one, there were two main things that I kept seeing popping up. So the first one was that it smelled like baby powder, and that was the main reason that I purchased it. Again, I like fresh scents. I love like baby powder scent, baby scent smells, like lotions and oils, deodorant. If it's like a baby fresh type of scent, that's me. So that was the main reason that I purchased this. And when you first spray it, it definitely has like this sweet powdery baby scent smell. But there was another thing that kept popping up in the reviews, and that is that it smells like an old woman. And what I will say is that, like I said, when you first spray it, it's very sweet and fresh, but as it settles into your skin, I don't want to say it smells like an old woman per se, but it definitely smells mature. So I can understand why people would write that. However, I do like this scent. This isn't an everyday scent for me. I still haven't figured out like the perfect occasion I would wear this to. But this is something that I would take like a nice hot shower and spray this on, put on some cute pajamas, pour me a glass of wine, and watch a good movie. Like, that's the type of vibes I get from this. I like it, but as popular as this scent is, I definitely don't think it's for everyone, because it is a mature scent. And so that's really the only two that I have that kind of fall in the fresh category. Now we're going to move on to florals, because again, I like floral scents. This next scent is Guilty by Gucci, and I only have the rollerball of this one and this smells really good. Honestly, I think like this is the perfect blend of like fresh and floral. So if you like fresh and floral scents like me, I think like this is the perfect combination. It kind of almost reminds me a little bit of the Chanel No. 5, but it definitely has, it's a little sweeter and it has more floral notes to it. Again, this is in the floral family. It's a warm floral, and the keynotes are some more words that I can't pronounce. Geranium, peach, and pink pepper. Yeah, I love this scent. I actually got my mom the big bottle of this because she smelled it on me one day and she was like, oh, that smells really good. And I ended up buying her the big bottle before I could buy me the full size bottle. But I definitely think that this is a good scent like for multiple age groups, like someone in their 20s, 30s, as well as older. My mom likes this scent a lot as well. And we're not talking about colognes, but I also bought my father the Gucci Guilty cologne, and that smells really good as well. So this next scent is a newer scent, and I've seen this like everywhere, especially around the holidays. And this is YSL Libre. This is another floral. It is a warm floral, and the keynotes are lavender essence, orange blossom, and musk accord. So this one was really, really hyped up, you guys. And I'm not gonna lie, it smells good. But I personally don't think that it lives up to the hype. Like, it smells good. To me, it's just like a standard floral. Like, this just gives me flowers. This is like an everyday go-to scent. Like, when I don't know what I wanna wear, I usually gravitate towards this one just because I know that it smells good. I feel like it's kinda good for any occasion. This one was definitely a little overhyped in my opinion, but I definitely think it's a good one to have in your collection. Again, a good everyday smell. When you wear it, you're guaranteed to smell good. So this next one is honestly my least favorite out of all the new perfumes that I have purchased. This is another one that I seen kind of hyped up on the internet, and it just did not live up to the hype for me. So this is Her by Burberry, and I had high hopes for this just because one of my signature scents is my Burberry, and I usually like the Burberry scents, but this one just it didn't do it for me. So this is another floral, and however, it's a fruity floral, and I should have known better because I do not like fruity florals. Fruity smells in general just smell really juvenile to me, and that's what this one smells like. So as far as the keynotes, it's dark berries, jasmine, and musk amber. Just smelling it now, like, it's so weird. So it definitely has like a berry scent to it, and it doesn't necessarily stink, but it smells almost like a body spray to me. Like, I feel like body sprays kind of have like that alcohol like after scent to it, and that's kind of how this smells. I don't know if it's the rollerball and maybe like the actual spray may smell differently, but I keep trying to give this one a chance, and every time I try to give it a chance, I do not like it. Like, when I smell myself all day, I'm like, why did I put this on? So I'm happy I did only get the rollerball because, like I said, I don't really care for this scent. It doesn't smell bad, but it just smells kind of juvenile in my opinion. Like, I think this would be good for like a teenage girl, someone in their maybe young 20s, but this just does not give me grown 30-year-old. Like, this just doesn't do it to me. So this next one is probably my favorite out of all the new scents that I purchased, and this is the Carolina Herrera Good Girl. So first of all, the packaging is everything. Like, the packaging alone sold me, and then when I found out it was a floral scent, I was like, oh yeah, I gotta try this one. So the packaging is just so cute. It's like a little stiletto heel. So this is a warm floral, and the keynotes on this one is tube rose, jasmine, and tonka bean. I love this one, you guys. This is a very soft, kind of sweet, sensual kind of scent. I think this one is good. Like, it's multi-purposeful. It's soft enough for where you can, again, wear it all day and it's not super strong and overbearing. However, I also think that it's sensual enough to where you can wear it like for like date night. I think this is the perfect date night scent, a good evening scent. I love this scent. My only complaint about this one is that I feel like it doesn't last very long. So it's so soft that, like, you know, as time goes by, it just kind of, the smell kind of drifts away. I'm not one of the type of people that reapplies perfume throughout the day, but this is definitely a scent where if you want to smell good all day and you know you have a long day ahead of you, I would purchase like a travel size to kind of keep in your purse or something if you want to touch up. But overall, I love this scent. It just smells so good, y'all. And so then the last one that I'm going to show you guys, it's not necessarily out of my comfort zone, but I think if I smelled this first in person, I might have passed on it. And not because it smells bad, but it's just a little different from the smells that I'm used to. So this is Marc Jacobs Decadence. And again, this is another one where the packaging alone sold me. So it's like this really cute purse and with the tassel, and the packaging on this is everything. This is a warm, sultry floral, and it has Italian plum, saffron, iris, Bulgarian rose, sambac, jasmine, orris root, warm liquid amber, velveteer, papyrus wood. This one is kind of hard to describe. Like I said, it's a floral, but it's a different type of floral than from what I'm used to wearing. But it smells really good at the same time. This is definitely not a everyday scent. I wouldn't necessarily classify it as strong, but it's a very distinct smell. And again, it smells good. This is definitely like special occasion, definitely like nighttime. It almost has like this like mysterious kind of intriguing scent to it. It's definitely, like I said, a lot different from all of the other florals that I have. But I'm definitely glad that I purchased this because it's, you know, it's something, it's nice to have a variety. You know, you don't want all of your scents to smell exactly the same. I wish I had a better way to describe it, but I don't, because it's just something that I'm not used to smelling. This is definitely like date night, going out with the girls, evening type of scent. But yeah, so again, Marc Jacobs Decadence. All right, you guys, so that's it for this video. Those are all the new scents that I purchased. So let me know down in the comment section if you have tried any of these, and let me know if you think they live up to the hype or if they are overhyped. And if you have any perfume suggestions, definitely let me know. But yeah, that is it. Thank you all for watching. Don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe. Follow me on Instagram, Smashed by Sharmell, and I will see you all in my next video.